Assalamualaikum. Welcome to Nordic Turns. Awareness from Halmstad student. Today I'm going to talk about Swedish Institute Scholarship for Global Professionals. So it calls SISGP, the new name actually. So if you are like ambitious, you have the leadership power in your work experience and it's very, very good, strong professional background, then you can apply for the master's program first and then you have opportunity to apply for the SISS scholarship. So this is a kind of full free scholarship for the master's program student from 34 countries, I should say. So this year rules and regulations are quite changed and I'm going to talk about how and from when you can apply for this SISS scholarship for Sweden study in the master's program. So the overview is the Swedish Institute is now launching their Swedish Institute Scholarship for the Global Professionals, a new scholarship program that replaces Swedish Institute Study Scholarship. So the previous name was SISS, that means Swedish Institute Study Scholarship, but now the name has been changed. It's a SISGP, like Swedish Institute Scholarship for Global Professionals. The scholarship program for the Swedish Institute Scholarship for Global Leaders, Global Professionals will be started from 4th of February to 14th of February. So you can start your application from 4th of February to 14th of February. So this time this scholarship program has been a little bit changed. So there has a little bit time for the university and university collaboration and universityadmissions.se and with the S-Institute.se. So there is three platform. One is university itself, the university you are applying, and then the other is the universityadmissions.se who control all the universities, and then si.se who controls only the scholarship program. So three platform will be in the one in the one group. So this time you will apply for your master's program in universityadmissions.se 16th of October 2018 to 15th January 2019. After that, if you apply, it will be late application. You can send your all the documents till 1st of February. 1st of February is the last date when your documents should be in the universityadmissions.se. If you send this document 30th of January or 31st of January, if it's like 2nd of February, it's arrived in universityadmissions.se, it will not be counted. It will count it as a late application. So don't do that. Just send your documents and other stuff a little bit early so that it cannot exceed 1st of February. So document sending deadline is 1st of February. And then from 4th of February to 14th of February, you will apply for the scholarship that calls SISGP, the new name of the scholarship. And then you will have your notification if you are granted for the master's program in the university or not, like the result of your admission will be published on 4th of April 2019, and then you will have the announcement of the successful scholarship holder that will be 26th of April 2019. So you have plenty of time to apply for the scholarship and to send the documents and to apply for the all the stuff like application and university choice and everything. So I would prefer that you are preparing yourself with the financially and the documents from the university, that you have the degree, certificates and everything, you have a nice preparation for that. Yeah, to begin with this scholarship program, how to apply and from when you can apply, just stay tuned with me. I should say like they will allow 300 scholarship among all over the world for 2019, and usually it takes 1-3% of the applicants, those who are awarded for the SISGP this year. So what actually included for this SISS scholarship? This SISS scholarship covers actually the tuition fees, because you don't need to pay the tuition fees, the whole tuition fees. Like if you are coming here for 2 years master's program in Sweden, and if you get SISGP scholarship, then you don't need to pay any tuition fee. Swedish government will pay the tuition fee for you to the university directly. So and then you will have living expenses for 10,000 Swedish crown per month. Previously, it was 9,000 Swedish crown for SISS scholarship, but this time Swedish government increased the money for the living expense because it a little bit changed. It's a little bit becoming really expensive here to live in. So that the dollar price is decreasing, and then Swedish and Swedish and US dollar and euro price is a little bit going inflated. So I should say that's why they increase the money. So living expenses will be 10,000 Swedish crown. That in Bangladeshi taka it's 1 lakh or 100,000 or 120,000 Bangladeshi taka. Okay, and then you will have a travel grant that you can go once in your country and then get back after the vacation. So it will cost like 15,000 Swedish crown. That in Bangladeshi taka it's 150 or 60,000 Swedish Bangladeshi taka. So I should say that it's also a facility that you don't need to pay anything if you want to visit your home country, and then again after the vacation you want to return back to Sweden. You will have a illness or accident insurance by Swedish government that will ensure your illness, your any kind of accident or any kind of health hazardous thing. If you get anything here, it will cover by the insurance company, so you don't need to pay anything for the health insurance or the medical insurance or some other things. You will have a future global leaders network. You will be included in the SI, or that means Swedish Institute Network for the Future Global Leaders, a platform that used to grow you professionally and build your network while you were in Sweden. So I would prefer that if I am an SISS holder, I can be the part of the global leader networks. So it's a very good opportunity for you, I think so. You will be the membership for SI alumni network, that who have the SS scholarship before, that they have a platform, and then you will be included with this platform. So you can work with them, you can learn from them how to take care of the future SISS global leader. So that's a little bit about the overview. What it doesn't cover, that is additional grant for the family members. Like you, if you want to visit to your home country with your family members, that Swedish government will not pay. That you have to pay to your family members. And then the application fee that you, when you apply for the universityadmissions.se, then you have to pay the application fee, that is 900 Swedish crown. It's 12,000 or 13,000 Bangladeshi taka. For the full time 1 year or 2 year master's program, and it is only rewarded for the program starting in autumn semester. So this program, this SIS GP scholarship, will be intended for the only for the autumn semester, not for other semester. That you have to in remind. This scholarship is granted for one academic year at a time, so it will be one academic year, not two. So at a time, it will be extended for the programs than two semester, provided the student has passed the course. Like if you don't pass the course, like after 1 year, then your scholarship will not be given for the next year. So you have to pass and you have to do a good result on the first semester or second semester. Otherwise, your scholarship will be eliminated. That the criteria that depends on your scholarship. Like sometimes I got some questions from you that what is the criteria that so that I can have the scholarship. So it's very tough to talk about this because Swedish Institute has a limited type of criteria guideline to choose the best global leaders for this scholarship, because this scholarship is very special. Only 300 students in all over the world, they will have this scholarship in Sweden every year. So I should say last year it was only five student or 80 student, I think 80 students from Bangladesh, they got this SISS scholarship. So among all the students, but previous year there were like 30 students or 25 to 30 students, they got the in different university, they got the scholarship. But still, it's now Bangladesh is not least developing country, it's a developing country. So the scholarship program is quite packed for our country. It's going to through the African countries who have like who still is a least developing country, I should say. Okay, so the criteria I'm talking about, that first criteria is the work experience, because they will choose the global leaders. So you need to have good work experience, and how they will count it. They will count it. You must have to have a minimum working experience for 3,000 hours. How they will calculate it? Demonstrated employment. What does it mean? Like you have a continuous work experience, not a little gap or something, unemployment or something. It should be demonstrated employment, like your job description and everything should be very clear. What does it mean, leadership experience? It means that if you have like 10 years work experience, so 10 years work experience, the 5 years should be in the executive position. So next 5 years, maybe you are a manager or you are leading some groups or some couple of people. So this 3,000 working hours in the leadership position will count. So this leadership experience is important. Not the work experience, not other things, but leadership experience is important. University admissions. Yes, you have to have a university admissions. Like you have to apply for the master's program in universityadmissions.se. And this application fee should be payable like 900 Swedish crown before applying. You will pay, because within 15 January you have to complete your application. So within this time you will pay your application fee, 900 Swedish crown, of course, and this is one of the criteria also. So, and then country of citizenship, like the four countries in which country you are from. So if you are from Africa or some other countries, you will have the scholarship in a very good way, because they treat like they have a 2030 UNDP development program goal, that in this time 10 year of time they will build some global leaders from all the developing countries in the world. So there is a development program in UNDP, United Nations Development Program. So they will choose the from the Africa or least developing country, of course. But for Bangladesh and some other countries, there are some other special scheme. If they have the leadership experience and work experience and some other criteria like they are looking for, then you will be chosen. So country of citizenship is also one of the criteria. So what is this goal for this scholarship? This goal is to enable the scholarship holder to play an active role for the positive development of the society in the developing countries where they live. So it's the one kind of invisible discussion that you have to get back to your country after the scholarship, if you get the scholarship. But if you have the job here, you will, of course, you will have a work resident permit, and then you can stay. So this is another issue. I should not talk about this. Required documents. What documents do you need for this? What documents you need to apply for this SIS GP scholarship? So first you need a motivation letter. This motivation letter is a specific form from SIS GP. So you must use this SIS GP form for your motivation letter for 2019 and 2020. So I should say that you should not use the other formats, but then they will not accept it. So a motivation letter is important, and this motivation letter will be available from January 2019. So you can download it and you can work on it, how to write it. So yeah, and a CV, like curriculum vitae. So this curriculum vitae, you must use the SIS GP format again for the CV. This CV should not exceed more than the page they will provide. So you should write only the things they need. You should not write anything, or you should not use any extra paper for the CV. You cannot do that, otherwise this CV will be rejected and you will not get this scholarship. So additional pages will not be considered. You will have two different types of reference letter, and this reference letter is also available in SIS GP. So you can start working on it. I will prefer that this two reference letter, one reference letter should be from your boss or from your immediate manager or line manager or supply chain manager or supply chain leaders or group leaders, of course, from your current employer. And then you have to have this kind of reference letter from outside of your employment. So it can be like some civil registry work voluntary work, or some kind of network who are involving with the public advancement of the developing country, something like that. So you can have this kind of reference letter from them as well. But it should be, they should recognize you when if SI.SE will check with them about you. So of course they should recognize you when they're referencing you. And you have to give them the proof of work and leadership experience. And what is the difference between work and leadership experience? Work experience can be like you have 10 years of work experience, like from the executive level, now you are a manager for a group of people. So this can be, this 10 year lifetime can be a work experience, like from 1 to 10 years you have a work experience. But for the leadership experience, like first 5 years maybe you are in executive position or maybe assistant manager or something. So this kind of work experience will not calculate or consider it for the leadership experience. So after 5 years to 10 years, these 5 years will calculate it for the leadership experience. So you should consider this 5 years maybe for the leadership experience and total 10 years for the work experience. I think you understand what I'm saying. Then you have a specific form for that. You can download it, and then you have to write your experience in the form, and then you will print it, and then you will chop it with the organization seal, stamped and other things, and then you will do a PDF with this printed copy, and then you will upload it in the SIS GP website when you are applying this. A copy of your passport is the identification for you, so that you are the country of this region, like you are from Bangladesh, so you have a proof for the identification that you are Bangladeshi or you have a Bangladeshi citizenship. So yes, a passport also needed, including your name, your citizenship and your photograph. It should be shown clearly that you are the person that you are applying for. With the CV, a copy of passport should be included together with the CV as a last page. So this is very important, that your passport should be included together with the CV as a last page, or that means CV and then there will be last page with your passport copy, so that it shows that this CV and your identification is close together with the PDF. So yeah, I think you understand what I mean. It is your responsibility to ensure that you have a copy of your valid passport to include. Of course, the passport should be valid till like 2 years or something. Of course, it should be at least should be 1 year, because this process will be very long process. So your passport will be valid, should be valid for the next 1 year or maximum like 5 years or at least 1 year. Yeah, make sure that you have completed your application by a complete motivation letter by their format, a CV of specific SIS GP format, to valid and complete letter of reference that I mentioned already, valid and complete proof of work experience and leadership experience. So first you need work experience and then leadership experience too. So, and then a copy of valid passport that you are the nationalities of the specific country that you are applying from. So your application, if your application is missing one of the required documents, your scholarship will be rejected. Scholarship application will be rejected. So I should say this is very important. A Bangladeshi student want to have this type of scholarship, I will prefer all the Bangladeshi students who should apply for this scholarship, and then good luck for you. So my next video will be about the IELTS program, because now the IELTS and the English requirement a little bit changed with the admission process this year. So I will talk about in the next video, I will talk about the IELTS requirement, what should you do about the IELTS requirement or English requirement. Okay, take my salam, prayers for me, and take care of all the Bangladeshi nationalities. Assalamu alaikum, Allah Hafiz, bye bye.